The problem of draining water cleaner from supercontractive substance is recently particular relevant. It is caused by the widespread use of the membrane technology for removal of heavy metal ions from industrial waste multi-component waters. In the combination schemes of equipment, materials used in nuclear power plants, composites containing sulfonyl with its analogs as mandatory components are widely used. Sulfonyl is usually used for desorption of non-polar contaminants from surface into desorption medium. At the same time, formation of colloids stimulates the formation of micelles, which include radionuclides and or heavy metals. Similar process of formation is a significant amount of industrial waste and enterprises which use surfactants. In the presence of drain waters of industrial effluent colloids virtually eliminate the possibility to membrane technology for removal of radionuclides and heavy metal ions. A significant amount of colloidal particles containing radionuclides and heavy metal in solution, which a precipitate reduces overall performance and survives life of membranes used. In this case, the drain weights, drain waters, for destruction of organic substance and accordingly colloids, the methods of ozone oxidation are used. To remove the micellium, surfactants of multi-component solution, which may contaminate radionuclides of heavy metal, we propose to use nano-suspended magnetite that is synthesized directly in these solutions. For our research, we research series of model solutions contained the anionic surfactants, salts of heavy metal, stable salts of cesium, strontium, and borate were prepared. For nano-dispersion magnetite, we used aqua solution containing salts of 2 and 3 trivalent ion with ratio 1:2:2. Total iron content in the solutions was 2 grams per liter. A solutions of iron salts were added to solutions of the model by two techniques. The required pH was maintained by alkali sodium hydroxide. Synthesis was performed at 60-70 Celsius degrees and constant stirring. The system was allowed to measure for 1 hour. The treatment was carried out as a constant magnetic field during the synthesis of the magnetic particles. First crystals were formed at pH 2.5. Later, a pH of 6, the change of magnetite particles of the opposite obtained, and at pH above 12, the synthesis of magnetite was considered as completed. Analysis of the magnetite structure obtained by X-ray fires analysis showed that such particles can be referred to a glandular spinel. Magnetite nanoparticles were prepared by different methods, with and without using EUV. Research has shown that most nano-dispersion magnetite particles distribution by number were obtained in the synthesis of magnetite introduction and alkaline into the solution of iron salts slowly and under the impulse magnet field within 5 minutes during the synthesis.
That's this slide.
Analysis of properties of the obtained magnetite show that the magnetization wall of the natural magnetite samples is more than the synthesizing magnetite samples B. But the nature of this dependence is similar. Infrared spectroscopic research has shown that the synthesis nanomagnetite under the influence of EMP has increased number of OH groups. In samples obtained without the influence of EMP and natural samples, they are completely absent. These results allow believing that the removal of anionic surfactants by magnetic nanodispersion is possible by formation of links between the sulfonic groups of surfactants and active centers of magnetite nanoparticles, heterocoagulation process, and for the removal of cations of alkaline earth metal and or heavy metals, we are included in the nanocrystal structure as isomorphic substitutions. It should be noted that the synthesis of nanoxide crystals of magnetite with the ability for removal of anionic surfactants with zeta potential and the increased amount of OH group should be carried in under compulsory impact of the pulsed magnetic field. To calculate of content of anionic surfactants in the aqua solution, we use the standard method of determination of the mass concentration of surfactants in the drink water, method of determining the content of surfactants. The essence of our method is the formation of anionic surfactants associated with methylene blue and alkaline medium and extraction of their associated by chloroform, followed by treating the results extracted with an acid to eliminate confounding factors and determining the concentration of anionic surfactants in the extract obtained absorption spectrophotometry. The efficiency of the removal is above 40% per cycle. Conclusions. Effect of a pulsed magnetic field on the synthesis and properties of the aqueous magnetite nanodispersion, which have improved absorption and coagulation properties, is caused by the increased amount of OH groups and the particle surface. The efficiency of anion surfactants removal is above 40% per cycle. The number of cycles is not limited. In the removal efficiency of each processing is repeated at the same level. The proposed method will not only clean the technologic multi-component solutions of surfactants and some of radioactive radionuclides and heavy metals, but also reduce the amount of colloids pass as a whole. That significantly increase its efficiency of traditional cleaning methods of the removal of radionuclides and heavy metals, such as membrane technology. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, now it's time for questions. Are there any?
You had to evaluate the possible effect of the ionic strength of your solution in the removal of disinfectants.
No, our research, we synthesized our non-dispersive aggregate kit with influence in positive magnetic field.
Please.
I do not understand what is the principal difference between your analog metallic approach with the classical coagulation approach.
In our researches, we have not a natural classical crystals of magnetite. Become it in solutions. First, this is colloid phase, and that is fairly good process of heterocoagulation. And then this is crystal phase, and absorption process dependence of OR groups. In this case, we behind this process.
Okay. Hello.
From practical point of view, how it's expensive? How fast you can clean, how much water you can clean during the day. So
we use salt of iron that chlorate and sulfate iron. Simply cheap. And this process may follow it periodical. But in big volume, process can be in big volume. This laboratory research,
масштабирование. Можно его масштабировать?
Можно. И это можно применить к промышленным водам и к жидким радиоактивным отходам.
Have a question? Maybe after this.
Yes, question. If you say about usability of this method, did you plan to make a kind of patent of this or contact with some industrial companies who can apply it?
We plan to have patent for this research, but we now don't have industrial
contacts.
As usual. Is the structuring of the surfactant important, for example, because we can have same surfactant with similar amount of OH groups, but then they will assemble in a different way. They will form maybe primary or secondary micelles, so big aggregates, so the amount of OH group that will be exposed will be different. Do you have an idea about the structural conformation of micelles have a key role?
We don't calculate how many this OH group we have. We show effect, we see effect, and we think how we can use it in practical.
Okay. So I think we can thank the speaker again.